Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jones.
Basically, you start out with massive amounts of data. You say, how are we going to analyze this? Well, let's fire up a pivot table and see if we can solve this problem.
Welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jellin. Well, today's question comes in from Peter. Peter wants to know how to do a VLOOKUP to do multiple results. So he has, you know, a cell up here where we can choose a product, and he wants to then see all of the orders for that product. You can see the orders over here, and there's, of course, multiple orders. Now, VLOOKUP is only going to return the first one. So I'm going to suggest that we don't use a VLOOKUP at all, that we use something called, well, in the old Excel, it's called Advanced Filter, and in the new Excel, it's out here on the data tab, it's in Sort and Filter, and then just Advanced now. So this is a pretty powerful feature in that you can do a lot of different things with it. You can use it to get a unique list of products. In this case, we have our database here, and I'm going to say that I want to copy to another location. The copy to is going to have the headings order and quantity. The criteria range is going to be this place where we have the heading of product, which has to match this heading here, and then the product that's chosen. And when we click OK, you see that it goes through and gives us all of those orders. So it's returning multiple values. Now, in this original set over here, if I would use Control T to define this as a table, and then I should be able to come back into data. Here, let's choose a different product. So C, Advanced, copy to another location, click OK, and you see that we now have the orders for C. Here's the real test. We're going to add a brand new item at the bottom. D, this is order 99999, and we'll come back into our Advanced Filter. Let's choose D's here, back into our Advanced Filter, and sure enough, it was smart enough to grow as the table grew. So we click copy to another location, and then OK. And you see that we get that new order. So, much better way to go. Of course, you're still going to have to go up and run the Advanced Filter, maybe record a little macro to run that or something like that. But better than using VLOOKUP, because it can return multiple results. I want to thank Peter for sending that question in, and want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.
Well, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel. We'll